Anna J. Cooper. On August 10, 1858, Anna Julia Haywood was born in Raleigh, North Carolina, to parents Hannah Stanley Haywood and George Washington Haywood. Hannah was an enslaved black woman, and George was the man who enslaved her. George was the son of North Carolina's longest-serving treasurer and co-founder of the University of North Carolina, John Haywood. Like most black women of the times, Anna worked for the Haywoods as a servant until the age of 9, when she received a scholarship to attend Raleigh's St. Augustine's Normal School and Collegiate Institute. The Episcopal Diocese of Raleigh founded the institute to train teachers to educate formerly enslaved black people. Anna spent 14 years at the institute and distinguished herself as a premier student in the subjects of liberal arts, mathematics, science, English literature, and she even mastered Latin, Greek, and French languages. Though the institute was designed to educate formerly enslaved people, it reserved its upper level classes for men until Anna challenged the institute, proving her intellectual prowess and succeeding in being admitted into the class. One of the young men in the class was George A.C. Cooper. The two would marry, but George died 2 years into the marriage. While completing her education at St. Augustine, Anna became a tutor to her fellow classmates. The money she earned from tutoring was used to pay for any expenses not covered by her scholarship. After graduating from St. Augustine, Anna became an instructor, teaching subjects such as classics, English, vocal and instrumental music, and history. The academic route Anna was following was designed for male students, but she was determined to receive the best education available. Her next step in her academic journey was moving to Ohio to attend Oberlin College, and was admitted as a sophomore because of how excellent her academic record was. She was well-rounded in her academic studies, but studying music was one of the reasons she chose to attend Oberlin. She had a reputation for taking as many courses as she could because she had a thirst for knowledge, but she did not have the time or capacity to take all the classes she wanted. Anna graduated from Oberlin in 1884 and was classmates with other notable black women such as Mary Church Terrell and Ida Gibbs. Anna was a member of a literary society, LLS, who hosted events featuring orchestras, singers, and well-known lecturers. Between 1884 and 1885, Anna taught at Wilberforce College. 1885 was the year she returned to St. Augustine to teach before deciding to return to Oberlin as a graduate student, earning her master's degree in mathematics. Anna and Mary Church Terrell were the first two black women to earn a master's degree in 1888. In the year 1900, she attended the first Pan-African Conference in London, England, to contribute her ideas to the upliftment of African people around the world. During her time in Europe, she visited many cities and landmarks. Let's go back a few years to the year 1892, the year Anna moved to Washington, D.C. Anna, along with Helen Apco Cook, Ida B. Wells, Charlotte Grimke, Mary Jane Peterson, Mary Church Terrell, and Evelyn Shaw, came together to form the Colored Women's League, an organization created to promote unity and interest in the black community. Anna took a teaching job at the M Street High School in 1901. She was eventually named the principal of M Street High School. Her time as the principal of M Street High School was cut short because of a difference in teaching philosophy with the school's governing body. She believed in the philosophy of W.E.B. Du Bois, while the school was structured by the philosophy of Booker T. Washington. She would later return to the school, but it was Anna once again taking a stand for what she believed could help her people. 1892 was the year Anna published her first book, A Voice from the South, by a black woman of the South. The book was well received and also led her to have public speaking opportunities while she spoke up for the rights of black people and women. Anna was a dynamic woman. After some time speaking publicly, she decided to let her pen do the talking for her. In 1883, Anna produced the classic paper, The Intellectual Progress of the Colored Woman in the United States Since the Emancipation Proclamation, while in Chicago, Illinois, attending the World Congress of Representative Women. As one of five black women invited to speak, she surely left her mark on the hearts and minds of the audience. Anna produced another remarkable paper in 1900 titled The Negro Problem in America. September 5th, 1902, she set the hearts of her people on fire when she delivered her speech, The Ethics of the Negro Question. 1914 was the year that Anna began pursuing her doctoral philosophy degree at Columbia University, but tragedy struck her family. Her brother's wife died and she adopted their 5 children, which caused her to stop pursuing her PhD temporarily. She faced many obstacles over a 10-year period in an attempt to earn her PhD. She also spent that time studying and preparing her dissertation, and in 1930, retiring as an educator from Washington Colored High School. Her retirement didn't last long. Soon she became the president of Frelinghuysen University in Washington, D.C. She worked at the school for 10 years and left the school at the age of 95. 30 years prior to leaving Frelinghuysen, at the age of 65, she became the 4th black woman in American history to earn a Doctor of Philosophy degree. Her journey that started 10 years earlier finally came to an end despite all the obstacles she faced. In 1964, at the age of 105, Anna Cooper died, leaving a great legacy in academics, literature, public speaking, civil rights, and women's rights. Several of her works were published, such as A Voice from the South, Slavery and the French Revolutionist, and The Voice of Anna J. Cooper, including A Voice from the South and other important essays, papers, and letters. Her writing, The Early Years in Washington, Reminiscence of Life with the Grimkes, was also published. She was born in slavery, but died a free woman. Free to educate and elevate herself and as many people as she could. Miss Anna J. Haywood Cooper, we proudly stand on your shoulders. For more information, make sure you visit my website at www.ontheshouldersone.com. There, you can support my On the Shoulders of Giants book series. Get all 3 volumes, if you please. You can also support me on Patreon at patreon.com/OTSOG. And don't forget to catch this next video that's coming up. And like this video and subscribe before you leave.